I'm Glenn Mann. I'm here with Pro Elite Greg Hackney. Greg, glad to have you out here today.
It's good to be here.
I bet it is.
It's a big week.
Hey, Greg, at this level of professional bass fishing, strategy plays a very important part to your success. Can you tell me a little bit about your strategy, how you approach a tournament, and you know, does it change a little bit from tournament to tournament, or you know, can you tell me a little bit about that?
You know, there are a lot of variables in fishing, and each tournament's different, but you know, like the Classic, there's more strategy in this tournament than any other because there's a lot of other things go on just besides the tournament itself, you know, that go along with it. But on a normal tournament, yeah, I try to think about everything. Here's a little different because locking's a deal. Most of the time we don't have to worry about locking. You know, you're in a big reservoir or a system where you can just run from one spot to the other. And so you have to manage your fish, manage your time, because we fish multi-day deals. A lot of people don't understand that. They think about one day, you know, you got to get on enough fish to last one day. Well, in our deal, you normally want to get a pattern, something that you can make work 4 days of the week, 3 days of the week with it being the Classic. And so there is a lot of strategy that goes on, and it changes a little bit with each body of water, the time of the year. You know, I think that's what makes one of these events so hard to win. There are so many variables. And then you think about 4 days of variables, the water, you're dealing with a creature that you have no control over, you know, that it's its own entity and it can do whatever it wants to. So, yeah, there's definitely a lot of strategy goes into this.
Now, for 2009, what's going to be your strategy this year? Are you going to be a little bit different from last year, or is it going to be pretty much the same? How's that going to change?
No, I think I change a little bit every year, try something new. Of course, last year what I started off with didn't work for me very well, but you know, this year I'm gonna try to fish a little more natural. Just kind of let things happen that are supposed to happen, and you know, I don't know if that makes any sense or not, but just kind of let the fish tell me what they want, and not let me dictate what I want to do. Let them dictate to me what I need to do.
So fishing a little bit more in the moment then.
Yeah, more in the moment. In the past, I think that's how I've had the most success. Of course, I've tried everything. You know, last year I probably swung a little harder. I wanted to win every tournament, which in what happens in a deal like that, you either fall on your face or you win. More times than not, you fall on your face. And in the past, I've been a more consistent type fisherman, and that's really, I feel better about myself that way. And so I'm just kind of going to go back and kind of fish the way I have in the past and just fish in the moment.
Kind of go with what you know. I like that. So have you ever won or placed really high in a tournament that you didn't feel you were really on top of your game?
Yes, actually I have. about every one I've ever won actually were situations where I felt like I could have done better. And most of the time it has been missed or lost fish. You know, not necessarily like I managed my time perfect, moved like I needed to, just had, you know, some missed opportunities that I didn't, still won, but I didn't feel like, you know, I have real high expectations, and it's hard for me to live up to my expectations.
I think that's true for a lot of us too, yeah. You know, if you have a bad day on the water, or maybe even have a bad tournament overall, how do you stay focused and keep that drive alive?
You know, actually, for me, I find a bad tournament probably drives me more than a good one because, you know, I'm real laid back after a good one. You know, everything's well. After a bad one, I'm so anxious to get back on the water to live up to my expectations.
What do you say, you know, when it comes to pros, you hear people like on website message boards and whatnot talking all these different things about, you know, the pros do this and that and the other thing. I'm sure you read them and you've seen this kind of thing. What do you think is the biggest misconception about the pros?
That this is a pretty easy life. You know, it's a big misconception. So many people I meet will say, man, it's great. All you have to do is fish. Now, let me understand this. All you do for a living is go fishing. You know, I'm also dealing, like I said before, with an animal that necessarily doesn't like me. And it's got to work out. You know, the two of us got to work together for, you know, everything to work in this deal. It's really, it's honestly, before I started doing it, I only seen the glory side of it. But now that I'm doing it, I get to see both sides. And there's a lot of things that go on. I spend an incredible amount of time away from my family. Now my kids are big enough. They're going to school, so they can't travel with me all the time. And I would say that's the hardest part. But, you know, I have a lot of obligations that I didn't have when I first started now. And there are just a lot of things that I don't think, a lot of people don't realize. They think about all the glory, in which the glory, honestly, is what, you know, keeps you going in this deal. But it's a lot of hard work goes into this. A lot of long days, daylight till dark on the water, 7 days in a row, no off time. When I go to work, I don't get a day off. It's every day, daylight till dark, you know, until the tournament's over or I leave and go to the next tournament.
Do you ever wish you could take a year off?
No, but one of these days I'm going to take off, but it's going to be for good. But no, it's one of those deals. For me personally, I need to fish every day. Like I like the way our season is now. I want to fish 7 days a week. When it comes time for us to be off, I want to be off till we start again. I don't like little breaks and then starting back. I want to go full bore till it's time to quit.
Well, when you're not doing the tournaments, you're working with your sponsors and you're also working with new product lines. And I'm just wondering, how much involvement does that take? How involved are you in creating a new product or doing tweaks to existing products?
Well, that one good thing about that, we don't have to take time off to do that. Like take these hooks for instance. We tweaked all these hooks while I'm fishing. Normally I do that in practice. I don't test a new product during a tournament, but I'm testing it during practice. So I've got a lot of on the water time with that product, which is better than somebody working in working inside a facility doing it. I'm actually got it out there where it's got to perform at, so that actually makes it easier.
Well, that's great. I was wondering, what can you, if you think back on your career and even basically your whole life, if you want to look at it that way, what would be the one defining moment, maybe the one important day in your life that changed your life forever?
Man, there's been a bunch. Probably the biggest one was the day I got married. you mean fishing or?
I want to kind of leave it open to you. I mean, what really change the way, either the way you think or the way, if you decide to become pro that day that happened, or anything that changed in your life that you said, from this day forward, it's going to be this way from now on, or I'm going to do this from now on.
I would actually say the biggest moment of my life was when my first son was born, because you really grow up overnight. I thought I was grown up, but until when I took on that responsibility, that was the biggest moment of my life, bar none, because at that time, I had to take care of another person. I was in total control of that, and that was up to me, and so that was really good for me. That probably actually helped my fishing, helped me to turn pro. I just turned pro, actually, and that all together was really, that was really a defining moment in my life.
Fantastic. That's awesome. Hey, a couple more questions, just to lighten up a little bit. You spend a lot of time on the road, like you mentioned earlier. You're with all these pros seemingly more often than you are with your family. I'm sure there's a lot of great camaraderie, and you start goofing off and playing practical jokes on each other. I'm wondering, what are some of the good practical jokes that maybe you've been involved in or you've seen happen?
There's probably some I can't tell, but there's a little bit of everything has went on with this group. We are kind of like a big family because we spend so much time away from our family. This is like our extended family. So, nothing really sticks out. I mean, they're all practical jokers, but nothing that maybe the banana that I put in Van Damme's boat before this tournament, and he didn't know about. That may be the best one so far.
Right on. So let me give you a moment here. I'm going to give you about 1 minute or so. I call it the shameless plug. You can talk about anything you'd like. You want to say something to the fans out there, or you can talk about a latest product or maybe a DVD or book that's coming out. Whatever you want to talk about, it's up to you.
Probably the biggest thing that with the economy and all, like it's been so bad the last year or so, and I've actually lost about half of my sponsors, but I really want to plug the ones that stayed: Triton Mercury, Strike King, Uvella, True Tungsten, Fish Harder Companies. It really means a lot because right now it's at the point that I honestly don't know if I could continue to do what I'm doing without them. And that really means a lot because that tells me how much the sport means to them, for them to do that. And the ones that were kind of fair weather sponsors, and they're still some of those out there, that's really big for them to do that. And to do that for all of us, because the industry sponsors are how we'll survive and how bass fishing will survive this whole deal.
Absolutely, absolutely. Hey, Greg, thank you very much for spending the time with us. Appreciate your time. Good luck at the Classic.
All right.